The untold truth about David Ortiz. Before we start, I would want you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Homer Hub. David Ortiz is one of the most famous and successful stars in baseball history. As a 10-time All-Star and 3-time World Series champion for the Boston Red Sox. It wasn't always quick though. Here is an interview of the untold true story behind the big papy legend that led people to hate him, and rightfully so, because he was there on luck and never achieved anything great in his whole career. He has had many feuds over the years till his retirement in 2016. Let's check out a bit of the story of Big Papa, aka David Ortiz. Background of David Ortiz. David Ortiz emerges easily from his passion for baseball. David's father, Enrique Leo Ortiz, who was born and raised in the Dominican Republic, was also a Pro Bowl player back in the 70s, but he never made the move to the Major League Baseball. But David Ortiz had never seen his father play. When Big Papi was born, Leo Ortiz left his diamond dreams to find a steady job to support his raising children. David Ortiz and his girlfriend Angela Arias were incredibly close too. In reality, he really went by the name David Arias during his first few years in baseball. Tragically, though, Angela Arias was killed in a car crash in 2002 when she was 46, so she never got to see him make it big. His career in the Red Sox. Though Ortiz is a Boston legend, he was originally drafted by the Seattle Mariners. Unfortunately for Ortiz, though, Seattle already has established stars at both of his positions. Paul Sorrento at first base and Edgar Martinez at signature hitter. That made Ortiz expendable. In a decision they would come to regret, the Mariners sent Ortiz as the player to be named later in a trade to the Minnesota Twins. Ortiz did get one of big thing out of his time in the Mariners organization though. While playing at their single A team in Wisconsin, Ortiz met his future wife, Tiffany. A Wisconsin native, Tiffany introduced Ortiz to another lifelong love, the Green Bay Packers. Since then, the Ortiz family has reportedly attended Packers games at Lambeau Field on a regular basis. Success or luck? In the summer of 1984, when Ortiz was 8, a gangly 16-year-old pitcher became a national hero when he took the mound of the Dominican Republic in the Summer Olympics. The pitcher was Ramon Martinez, who was soon signed by the Los Angeles Dodgers. And over the years, he and his young brother, Pedro Martinez, became idols to a whole generation of Dominican players, including Ortiz. So it was almost fate then, following an injury, Merritt's 2002 season with the Twins, Minnesota decided to cut Big Papi rather than risk paying him more money in arbitration. Pedro Martinez, who was then the star pitcher for the Boston Red Sox, happened to run into Ortiz later that very day and was thrilled to hear the news. Martinez wrote in the Players Tribune, "I jumped in the air and clapped. We needed a first baseman in Boston, and I knew that could be David." Got his phone, he called Larry Lucchino and basically told them, "This guy is special." So 2 days later, the Red Sox signed me, and here I am. The scandal. During the mid-2000s, Major League Baseball was hit with a major doping scandal that implicated many of the game's top sluggers in the use of performance-enhancing drugs. Mark McGwire, Jason Giambi, Rafael Palmeiro, and Barry Bonds were just some of the stars exposed by evidence that they had used steroids. What about Ortiz? Well, in 2009, the New York Times published an article reporting that Ortiz's name was on a 2003 list of big league ball players who had failed a drug test. Ortiz later strongly denied the allegations in a press conference, saying the most he did was use legal nutritional supplements. He said to the media, "I definitely was a little bit careless back in those days when I was buying supplements and vitamins over the counter. Legal supplements, legal vitamins over the counter. But I never bought steroids or used steroids." Ortiz's name has ever been linked to any steroids use since. Or has any evidence ever been found actually linked linking him to performance-enhancing drugs. The attack! On the evening of June 9th, 2019, Ortiz visited the Dial Bar and Lounge. That's where a man approached the baseball legend and from just a few feet away, shot him in the back. Ortiz was rushed to a hospital, where doctors had to remove parts of his gallbladder and intestine in what was described as a 6-hour procedure. The Red Sox then chartered a plane to fly him back to Boston, where he underwent another successful surgery at Massachusetts General Hospital. His wife Tiffany Ortiz reported that her husband was, quote, stable, awake, and resting comfortably in the ICU. Within the week, Dominican Republic's National Police announced that several suspects in the attack had been arrested and that the would-be killers had been paid roughly $7,800 to kill Ortiz. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also watch the two videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you in the next video.